Ladies and gentlemen, Daddy had to go back home, baby. I said, Daddy had to go back home. And by that, I mean I went back to the New Orleans Saints playbook. A playbook that I had great success with. But I don't want to be stuck to one scheme too much. So I decided to switch playbooks, hop around, and see if I could find other playbooks that I like. And Jacksonville was one of them. Minnesota really wasn't. So I'm going to stick around with New Orleans just for a little bit until I go on ahead and find myself another playbook. I'm actually going to have to go in the practice lab and work out a playbook instead of just picking a random playbook, going online and, you know, trying to work it out there. So, but for now, until we get our next playbook, we're going to rock it on out with the New Orleans playbook, a playbook that I've been using since the beta. So I have plenty of time, plenty of hours maxed in with this playbook. So hopefully it can get us on the right track of things, because I've been struggling pretty bad with that Minnesota book. Even though we were winning majority of our games, still was struggling a little bit as he tries to go to the slant. But we're hawking the middle, baby. I'm sorry, son, but no Sophia right there. The good old run game that I like. Single back counter, and then we got the pistol strong power. And, you know, I feel comfortable passing out of these formations. I feel comfortable running out of these formations. When I'm forced to pass, I like the passing formations that New Orleans has. And I just all around just, you know, feel very comfortable with the playbook. No matter what it is you force me to do or take away from me, you know, I feel like I can move the ball consistently. And I know I can find other playbooks to do the same. And I will. Right there was just a skosh behind that one. 4th and 9 right here. And he decides to go towards the outside. And we did end up shading towards the outside. And thankfully, we end up getting that played. So Madison comes away with the pick. Right here, standing in the pocket. I'm looking. Nobody's open. So we're just going to go ahead and take off with Russell Wilson. And that is where mobility is good. Even though this is a playbook that really flat out doesn't utilize his mobility. It's a football. We got a big hit right there. Tamba Holly killed him. We got to go on ahead and, yeah, so even though this playbook doesn't really utilize his mobility like that, still, I guess it's just good to be able to take off just in case you're in a situation like that. Everything is locked up and you can just take off. But I do have my eye on that new 90 Roethlisberger. That card looks good. He looks like a very good thrower, and he has, you know, 74 speed, which it can get the job done. You know, it's good enough to get the job done. So here we go back again with another game. Our first opponent quits. So this time we end up with the ball first. And, oh, man, I thought I should have just kept going upfield. I don't know why I literally turned right into him. And right there wasn't the best run. I turned right into the offensive lineman, too. I should have kept going upfield. So kind of just not really reading the rushing lanes too well. So on 3rd and 9 right here, we end up hitting the out route right there out of Snugs. And we end up throwing a dot right there. So back to the running game we go. Ah, how do you not pick up that block? How? It was like laid right in front of you. How do you not pick up that block, man? As great as LeSean McCoy is, just for his speed purposes, because once he gets in the open field, he's very difficult to track down. And I've ran the ball with, you know, McCoy, even 90 Gurley. And both, I mean, not McCoy. Obviously, I ran the ball with McCoy. I ran the ball with, I should say, Ricky Williams and 90 Gurley. Both of those guys have like 89, 90 speed. But I don't know. It's just this McCoy just separates himself when he's out in the open field. But he doesn't really break tackles like that. You know, like Gurley and Ricky Williams, oh, they would just put their shoulder down, run through guys, and break tackles. McCoy doesn't really do that. So I need to have more of a balance when it comes to running, because I rely heavily on McCoy a lot, and I'm not really breaking tackles with him as I did with other running backs, which is expected. Yeah, I know he's elusive, but, you know, I shouldn't be running over guys, you know, like, excuse me, like how Ricky Williams and how, you know, Gurley and Dumb could. But, you know, when Gurley and Ricky Williams hits the outside, they just don't separate themselves nowhere near how this McCoy does. So right here, first and 10. We go towards the outside trying to get that back shoulder fade, man. Just couldn't really connect. And then right there, good throw. Just unable to keep our feet in bounds. Third and 10, we're just going to play safe, play for the field goal, going ahead and running. Hey, plenty of times I have done that and end up getting more yards or even scoring. But in that situation, we don't. But, you know, I understand we were going to go on ahead and settle for the field goal anyways. Didn't want to risk a pass and make a bad read or stop the clock with an incomplete pass or anything like that. So, right at first and 10 for him and just unable to connect, even though he had space over there. Goes to the toss right here. Click on and I try to dive and bring him down, but McCoy breaks the tackle. See, my McCoy don't be doing that, man. Right, you know, you can tell this guy just had trouble passing the ball. He had guys open over there on the right side, just didn't make the correct read. Right here goes over the top. That right there was the correct read. Very good pass right there. Just threaded the needle up the seams right there. And then he goes over the middle, and he had the crossing route going towards the left. Decides to go towards the other one and end up making an incomplete pass. So, third and 10 right here. Play action, and good pass right there. So, now he's starting to get some better passes here. And that's no bueno, right? Again, we don't want that. We don't, you know, we're trying to hold him to a field goal here. But McCoy has other plans as he ends up diving right into the end zone. And he missed his PAT, which is always good for me. So up 10-6. We're going to see if we can at least get a field goal range here. We only have one timeout with 30 seconds remaining. You guys know in Madden, there's plenty of time. Right here, the in route just wide open. So we throw that and we end up no huddle. So I'm looking with Russell Wilson. We go deep over the middle. And Fitzgerald does end up dropping the ball. So second and 10, we go to a quick out route, and we just get out of bounds with 5 seconds remaining. Enough time to squeeze in one run, dive down, and call timeout, which is exactly what it is we do as I get a phone call right here. Let me go ahead and decline that. So we end up going up 13-6. So we end up going up a full touchdown due to him missing that PAT. Right here, he just flat out PA all go, man. Just streaked everybody. Man just streaked everybody and found an open receiver. So, hopefully we cannot give up a touchdown here. And he goes over the middle, and I'm just too slow. But Harrison Smith does make a play. And I highly endorse that Harrison Smith, man. I definitely think he's better than Larry Wilson. He has been playing fantastic for me. Really, really, really enjoy his level of play. Second and 7. There we go, man. We end up diving down. Bringing him down for a 1 yard gain. He goes to the flats. I don't know how that was caught, but he negates the field goal right here. I don't know how, like, literally, it was just 2 man under out of quarters, and Aaron Donald just ran straight through the A gap. I don't know how. Believe me, if I knew how to do that, I would do it more often. I don't know what the hell happened. I just know he didn't go for his field goal, and he ends up just getting A gap for whatever reason. Right here, just playing. You know, a little too conservative, and we end up forcing me to punt the ball. But I'm not really worried about his offense. You know, we feel okay punting the ball, playing conservative. You know, we've been able to shut down a good majority of his plays. If it wasn't for, you know, how did he get in scoring position last time? Was it a deep streak, I believe? I don't know. Nonetheless, we end up bringing the heat, forcing an incomplete pass. Very next play, he goes over there towards the left side, and we end up forcing an incomplete pass where he ends up quitting. So that's the end of the video, fellas. We're back on the winning side of things. We're back with a playbook we feel comfortable with, both running and passing. Hopefully you guys enjoy, man. It's your boy GS. We're going to go on ahead and be signing out. Peace. Give it to me, baby.